As the contentious four-year term of President Donald Trump nears its end, Democrats and a growing number of Republicans believe it cannot happen soon enough. Less than a week after this violent mob sieged our nation's capital in an effort to change the outcome of the election and mollify their leader, a handful of lawmakers are now pushing to have their leader removed from office and barred from ever serving again, making President Trump the first in history to face impeachment twice.
My friends, we are in a very difficult place in our country as long as Donald Trump still sits in the White House.
The resolution charges President Trump with incitement of insurrection for his repeated claims of winning the election and his speech on January 6th, just before rioters breached the Capitol.
We're going to try and give them the kind of pride and boldness that they need to take back our country. So let's walk down Pennsylvania Avenue.
The four-page impeachment bill reads in part, President Trump gravely endangered the security of the United States and its institutions of government. While some have questioned impeaching the president so close to the end of his term, Democrats and others argue that he should be held responsible and prevented from ever being able to hold public office again.
Resolution calling on Vice President Michael R. Pence to convene and mobilize the principal officers of the executive departments of the cabinet to activate Section 4 of the 25th Amendment to declare President Donald J. Trump incapable of executing the duties of his office and to immediately exercise powers as acting president.
Lawmakers first called on Vice President Pence and the cabinet to invoke their constitutional authority to remove Trump from office using the 25th Amendment. But that effort was blocked by Republicans. The House is expected to vote and pass this resolution within the next few days. A Senate vote will then be required for impeachment. Reporting for NewsNet, I'm Abigail Taylor.